Good evening. First tonight, the dramatic smash on the Bolte Bridge that left a truck dangling over the edge and its driver with horrific injuries. He plummeted 20 metres from the rig's cabin onto the road below. The crash bringing Melbourne's morning rush hour to a grinding halt. And there's no relief in sight with the mayhem continuing into this evening's peak. Sarah Arbo begins our coverage.
The cabin and one of the trailers of the city-bound tip truck was left hanging precariously off the Bolte Bridge. 20 metres below, the driver lay on concrete rubble, injured but conscious.
He's saying he couldn't breathe and I was having difficulties breathing. Thought his shoulder was broken he couldn't move his... He couldn't feel his legs.
Major collision investigators say the truck slammed into the bridge's barrier after swerving to avoid a car about 6:30 this morning near the Racecourse Road on-ramp. The driver was thrown from the truck's cabin, the vehicle jackknifing and travelling a further 10 metres. It's believed a street light may have broken the driver's fall, a nearby worker going to his aid.
Obviously thought he was, a goner, so he was asking for someone to hold his hand, so I just held his hand. And, luck was on his side, I'll give him that. Yeah, definitely very lucky man. Hopefully he pulls through.
Aged in his 30s, he was taken to the Royal Melbourne Hospital with serious injuries. The car driver, aged in his 20s, was taken to the Alfred.
I mean, it's a pretty intense sort of horrific sort of incident, but it just goes to show that there's been some safety in the design and has worked to some degree.
The MFB used its new cyber quad drone to assess the damage and work out how to safely move the truck.
The force of the collision was so strong, bits of concrete debris were thrown more than 30 metres down the road.
Look, I haven't experienced this type of thing in recent history, that we do know when we have a heavy vehicle involved in a collision on the road network, particularly the metropolitan network and particularly at the early morning peak hour, well then there are serious ramifications.
As one of the city's main arterials remained closed off, heavy haulage equipment was brought in. Secured from above and below, cranes eventually lifted the truck back onto the bridge. The damage caused to a vacant warehouse below also raised concerns about asbestos, with water doused on the roof to reduce the risk.
And Sarah Arbo joins us now from just below where this smash happened. Sarah, what's the condition of the truck driver tonight?
Good evening, Stephen. The 39-year-old truck driver from Roxburgh Park is tonight fighting for his life at the Royal Melbourne Hospital. He suffered serious head and lower body injuries. The driver of the car, a 25-year-old man from Spotswood, is at the Alfred in a stable condition with suspected broken bones. What we know from police is that the driver of the car was attempting to merge in front of the truck, which caused the truck to swerve, jackknife, and the driver was flung onto the road below. What we don't know is whether the truck driver was in fact wearing a seatbelt. Now, investigators say they will piece together and reconstruct the incident to try and determine just what happened and to try and prevent such an incident from happening again. They are, of course, appealing to any motorists who were driving past at the time to come forward with what they saw. Now, this has caused chaos throughout Melbourne on the roads, on the rails. We know buses were replacing trains for some time on the upfield line as cranes removed the truck. But the real chaos was felt by motorists, as TEN's Yasmin Payton explains.
Two vehicles crash and thousands are brought to a halt.
Once one thing breaks, then yeah, it's a fragile system. Everything falls to pieces.
It's just another day in Melbourne.
Drivers forced to turn around on the Racecourse Road on-ramp, away from the truck hanging precariously over the side of the Bolte Bridge.
The closure of a freeway, a major freeway, for many, many hours is always a high impact incident.
Some commuters were concerned about others.
The guy in the truck, hoping he's okay.
Most expressed frustration about Melbourne's road network.
It's ridiculous that one accident can cause such havoc. It's crazy. It's taken me over 3 hours to get somewhere that normally takes me 35, 40 minutes.
CityLink refused to waive tolls, adding to the anger.
You're kidding. When it beeped, I couldn't believe that.
The Tullamarine Freeway was closed at Flemington Road, causing traffic jams across northern and western suburbs.
I've never known CityLink to be shut down for this long because of a car versus a truck accident.
And it really does clearly demonstrate the need for alternatives in the freeway network.
Such as the East-West Link and Metro Rail Project.
Is that they both would be useful, but as we know, they're both very costly.
A cost the state can't cover.
We want both. Melbourne needs both. I want both. Our government wants both.
and we hope that we'll be able to move from one to the other based on agreement with the federal government on funding and timing.
There could be more delays to come as repair works are carried out on the damaged bridge.
Need to ensure that the infrastructure is back to full working order and safe before we can reopen to traffic.
How long it will be before it's fully repaired, CityLink won't say.